Hi. So our today's tutorial is going to be the vortex coils. This is our last shape we are going to see in the series. Then we will move on to scrolls. I just love making these vortex coils. They look so pretty, isn't it? I love to see them make those lines inside. So let's get to it. So this is how the pack of quilling strip looks. So each pack has about 100 strips. So you try to remove your strip from the middle. So when you remove from the corners, the whole thing is going to come off. So find out the middle portion and you take a strip from the middle portion, so it's easier to pull out the strip without much difficulty. Don't go to the outer side, pull your strip from the inner so that the inner U comes out easily. As far as possible, try to keep the whole strip in its own pack. Otherwise, it's going to become a big mess. And once your quilling strip is spoiled and it's getting creases, your shapes are not going to come out properly. So keep it in its own pack like this. So for this vortex shape, you are not going to make the loose coil. Keep it tight and you are going to let the coil loosen on its own. So first you make your coil. So as I said before, don't spoil the natural flow of the strip. Don't make it too tight nor too loose. Go with uniform pressure so that you get a nice vortex coil. Vortex coil, not everyone will get it perfect in the first try. So keep trying till your shapes come out perfectly. By practice, it's really easy. So here you don't need to stick your coil. Just pinch, but be sure to pinch it, as I told you, along with the strip ending. So pinch nicely. You have to give a good squeeze. Just a slight pinch will not give you a good vortex coil. So the more you pinch, you will get a good shape formed. So you can even keep down on the table and push, but be careful not to let go of the coil, otherwise everything is going to unwind. You can keep it down and push or do whatever. Make sure you get the crease at the corner. It should form a tight eye shape or like a leaf shape, or it should have a good shape like this. And then keep it in one of the sizer slots. Let it open on its own. Now if it doesn't open up, if you squeezed it too tight, it's not going to open up. Slightly keep nudging it so that it opens. Hold it in between your fingers and open the center portion with the help of a tweezer. By practice, you will get it to open by itself. If it doesn't, no worries. You can always use your toothpick or your tweezer to open out till the last winding. Now you can see the shape already forming here. So go till the last part comes out. Yes, we are done now. So now pick it up. Now you can see the coil here. So once you are satisfied with the shape, you can just pull this and adjust the last layer, and then you can stick the end part of your strip. Can you see that design there? That looks like a vortex, and it's aptly named as the vortex coil. We will do one more. So first let me remember to pick the strip from the inside. Pinch it. Remember, don't make your coils too tight nor too loose. The right pressure of the coil gives you a nice vortex. Make sure you make that crease at the outer part of the coil. Leave it inside your circle sizer. Remember not to use too much glue, just a tiny drop is good. One last time, we'll do this. Hope you can see it unwinding on its own. Slightly nudge it if it's not moving. And then you can use your tweezer to move. So if you want a bigger vortex, you can just attach two strips together. So you will get a bigger vortex coil. I'm going to use all these shapes to make my mandala. So I'm okay with this size. On our next video, I'm going to show you my mandala project and how I'm going to use all these basic shapes to create my beautiful wall art. So don't lose hope when you don't get your vortex on the first try. Keep trying, and you're going to get a beautiful coil. Thank you.